Papia Datta, working as a lecturer in the Mahalakshmi Polytechnic College. Today I am going to start with the fourth chapter of applied electronics, that is oscillators, and that is waveform generators. And now today we are going to start with the first topic of fourth chapter, that is oscillators. So an oscillator is basically a signal generator that produces a sinusoidal or non-sinusoidal signal of some particular frequency. Oscillators find their various applications as these are the fundamental component of any electrical and electronic circuits. Continuous oscillations are the basis of working of an oscillator. Sometimes an oscillator is said to be an amplifier with a positive feedback, or more specifically a feedback amplifier with an open loop gain equal to or somewhat greater than 1. At the time of defining, we say oscillators are generators. But more specifically, oscillators are energy converter that transforms DC energy into equivalent AC energy. The frequency ranges of the AC signal at the output of oscillator ranges from a few hertz to several gigahertz. Now we'll talk about the block diagram of an oscillator. So this is the block diagram of an oscillator. So an oscillator is nothing but a combination of amplifier along with a positive feedback circuit. The figure below represents the block diagram of an oscillator. Here the feedback network is the frequency selective circuit. The oscillator circuit employed before the amplifier circuit in the figure can be LC tank circuit, RC network, or watch crystal. The amplifier basically changes the DC voltage provided by the supply into AC power. This AC signal is then given to the tank circuit through a feedback path. Further, the oscillations of the tank circuit are fed to the amplifier. Since the amplifier amplifies the applied input at its terminals, thus at the output of the amplifier, amplified oscillations are achieved because of the applied DC voltage. As we know that we have employed a positive feedback circuit over here, the reason for this is that feedback provides a part of the output to the oscillatory circuit in the correct phase so as to have sustained oscillations. Now let's just take a minute and try to answer these questions. The dash feedback is used in oscillators. If there is no signal at input applied, what triggers the operation of oscillators? And if in positive feedback, both input and output are what? Hope you got the answers. So the positive feedback is used in oscillators. If there is no signal at input applied, what triggers the operation of oscillators? The answer is noise voltage. And in positive feedback, both input and output are in phase with each other. So these are the answers A, D, E, B. Now let us move forward and talk about the circuit operation of an oscillator. So here, this is a figure of this figure represents the basic oscillator feedback circuit. Suppose Vi, so this is the Vi, is the input applied at the terminal of the amplifier having gain A. Also a feedback network is used here, that is beta. This feedback network has the feedback fraction beta. The output of the amplifier is V0 and that of the feedback network is Vf. Here the output of the feedback network is Vf. So here beta basically defines the fraction of output which is provided as feedback to the input. Initially Vi is applied at the terminal of the amplifier with gain A. So at the output of the amplifier we get A V0 equal to A Vi. This voltage is then provided to the feedback network, which is basically a resonant circuit, in order to have the highest frequency highest feedback at a frequency. So the signal applied at the output of the feedback amplifier is given as A beta V0 or Vi, A beta Vi. So since Vf equal to beta V0 and V0 equal to AVi, So if the amplifier and feedback circuit introduces 0 degree phase shift, then both the feedback signal as well as the input signal will be in phase with each other, as we are using positive feedback. Now when the output of the feedback circuit is provided to the amplifier along with the input, then the signal at the output of the amplifier will be given as V0 equal to A into Vi minus beta V0, that is the feedback. V0 equal to AVi minus A beta VV0. Put the AVi in the left hand side and V0 to the left hand side, right hand side. And AVi equal to V0 plus A beta V0. Take V0 as common. The AVi equal to V0 1 plus A beta. Now we can write the closed loop gain of the oscillator with feedback G. Gain is denoted by G equal to V0 upon Vi equal to A upon 1 plus A beta. Suppose we provide only the output of the feedback circuit and the input of the amplifier and the remove the originally applied input signal. After the removal of Vi, the loop gain of the oscillator is responsible for sustained oscillations. If the open loop gain is less than 1, that is A beta is less than 1, then after some period of time the output will die out. This is so because where A beta Vi serves as input to the amplifier. So this will be less than Vi and A beta will be less than unity. Hence each time after passing the loop, the amplitude of the signal will get reduced. Resultantly, oscillations will die out. If loop gain is more than 1, that is A beta is greater than 1, then it causes the output to get built up. Then each time on passing the loop, it increases the amplitude of the oscillations. Now if the loop gain is equal to 1, that is if A beta is equal to 1, then it causes Vf to be equal to Vi. Thus at the output, the signal will be continuous sinusoidal waveform. In this way, the input is itself provided by the circuit and hence the sinusoidal output is achieved. It is to be noted here that initially the loop gain is always more than 1 in order to build up the oscillations. But once a certain voltage is reached by the signal, then the loop gain now becomes 1. This is due to the non-linear behavior of the feedback amplifier circuit. Now we'll talk about the difference between an oscillator and an amplifier. So first parameter is definition. So an amplifier is a circuit which amplifies the weak signal and raises the amplitude of the signal. Whereas an oscillator is a circuit which generates the AC waveform of a particular frequency for providing source to an electronic circuit. Next parameter is function. So an amplifier is used repeatedly in a circuit because the signal loses its intensity after traveling to a long distance. And an oscillator is used only in the initial stage when the circuit requires signal source. If I talk about feedback, so amplifier uses negative feedback and oscillator uses positive feedback. Now we'll talk about the requirement of input. The input is required for its operation. It cannot operate without input. Oscillator, it does not require any input to perform the operation. And next, last parameter is type of signal generated. The signal can be periodic or non-periodic in case of amplifier, and in case of oscillator, the signal generated by it will be always periodic in nature. Now let us take a minute and try to answer these questions. Theoretically, the gain in the oscillator must be equal to what, and basic difference between oscillator and amplifier is dash, and gain stability in an oscillator can be achieved by out of which. I hope you got the answer. So theoretically, the gain in the oscillator must be equal to 1, and basic difference between oscillator and amplifier is no input signal needed, and gain stability in an oscillator can be achieved by controlling the gain. I hope you have understood the basic concept of an oscillator. Thank you.